Friday, Thursday. Okay, yeah, there are two things. Number one, okay, after King Wei. Violet Yeung and Christina Chiu's form being hacked yesterday.
Modi's
one also hacked. Now, last night, my phone also kena hacked. Alright, so I've received a lot of messages from
unknown people.
Unknown people asking me what message I've sent them. Which I have no idea also myself. Obviously, my phone number has been used by somebody has without my authority and my knowledge used my phone number to send messages to other people. Alright, so I call upon our opponent not to resort to such uncalled for tactic. And the MCMC, right, should have the ability and authority to deal with such matter. Right, even our official website has been blocked. DAP Sarawak, is it? Google? Yeah. Live stream? Okay, now restore back. I think that yesterday, okay, yeah, but this one, I think the hacking of the phone and unauthorized, so I call upon our supporters and the member of the public in these elections, when you receive messages allegedly, apparently from the DAP leaders, don't take it at first face value. You can always ask. You know, just call up and ask, all right, if you have queries about the content of the phone, of the messages that you receive. I think now this afternoon, last night, around 10 o'clock, starting around 10 o'clock, I received about 50 over messages asking, responding to a message that was supposedly to be sent by me, but not sent by me. Yeah, using my phone number. Okay, so but this is the how the I don't know.
But what was the message you asking about?
Okay, I think the message is in Mandarin. It should be in Mandarin. You know, something maybe like support DAP or I don't know. Seriously, you know. So I've received a lot of. For the Malay messages that reply to my so-called message, it's apa tu? Apa yang cakap? You know, so it tries to portray an image that DAP only send out Chinese messages. Try to alienate, you know, by doing so, trying to alienate our Malay supporters, Dayak supporters, right? Using our number to send out only Mandarin Chinese messages. Whereas DAP now, most of our messages, even you look at our banners, our pamphlets, are all in either two languages or three languages. We don't have any pamphlets in one language now. Alright? That is how diverse DAP has become and how multiracial we are serious about it. If you look at SUPP pamphlets, they still have Chinese pamphlet. It was a pamphlet solely in Chinese, Mandarin language. Or a pamphlet solely in Bahasa language. Okay? But it, for DAP, we only have pamphlets in at least two languages or even three languages. Alright? So that's why by sending out only messages in one language, they are trying to, the sender of this message, try to paint a picture that, you know, DAP only is only a China party, party China, Chinese party, and we don't want to alienate our Dayak supporters or Malay supporters. Alright, we do not, alright. Okay, so I call upon our opponent not to use such, resort to such underhand tactic. In this election so far, we have discovered so many of these underhand tactic, dirty tactic. Number one, the banning of our leaders from coming to entering Sarawak while allowing UMNO cabinet minister, they are now even having a PC, just finished a cabinet meeting into Sarawak. Right. Number two, the import of West Malaysian armies, army personnel to vote and their family members to vote to elect our state government. Right. Number three, using such illegal, even illegal tactic, impersonating our phone number, impersonating our phone number to send out messages. That's number three. And number four, if you look at the Facebook website, a lot of smearing campaign is going on. So all these four. And number five, of course, the use of government machinery and people's money to help in the campaign. Right, therefore, it is an irony that Najib has openly called for do not be bought, do not sell your vote for money. Okay, so five underhand tactics that has been engaged to fight DAP. Okay, all right. Okay, that's number one. How was the Ishia Jiang? Ishia? Okay, ha. This one I will speak in Chinese, the next one. This is more on. Okay, on Dr. Sim and this. 这个有文告的，我这边讲出来先。 人民党今天在现如今在这个四角的战役，基本上就是告诉人民，如果沈慧娴中选，就有一个副部长，副首席部长，以副首席部长的职位来诱惑四角的选民。 好，在这里，我今天发的文告如下：人民党已无副部长，根本就不影响华社华族的权益，反而是人民党在其最辉煌的时段，其党连本身的权益和地位都不保，更妄论要替华社争取权益。我现在举出下列几件事情。 来证明人联党是在其最强盛的时候，其党的权力和地位被逐渐的削弱，而又不敢出声。第一，有九件事件啊。第一，八十年代，这个人联党在周内阁有三位正部长。 到了2000年代，人联党只剩下两个正部长。OK， 这个是第一个事情。第二个事情，80年代人联党管辖的古晋市 被划分为古晋南北市，人联党所获得管辖古晋南市，是原本古晋市的三分一的面积，人联党所管辖的范围缩减三分二，就连比古晋更大、人口更多几倍的吉隆坡也只有一个市长，人联党的所管的古晋市却变成两个市长。Okay, 这个是第二件，他们的权力被侵蚀。第三，1987年，人联党的布拉嘎选区被土巴党夺取，本来是人联党的，给土巴党了。第四，1990年，人联党丢失了斯利阿曼议会主席的职位。第五，1996年，人联党的斯无西端区被划出了另一个南嘎区，现在的南嘎。好，但这个新选区非由人联党出战，反而是给土保党夺取。你要不用写，有等一下会 email 给你们。好，这个可以你拿去。不是另外一个，这个 OK。第六，1997年，斯无乡村议会署理主席之职是当时国政里排行老三的国民党拿去，本来是人联党的给国民党拿去，大概是1997年。第七，2004年，人联党坐镇40年的斯无乡村议会主席之职被民进党取代。2005年，人联党的州财政部长之职被首席部长取代，并兼任人联党原本的财政部长制被贬为第二财长制。2005年同一年，人联党掌权的本来是主席的职位，砂劳越电力局之职被土保党取代。以上的事件都是发生在人联党全盛时期，也是人联党有副首席部长的时期。人联党连其本身的权力和地位在其全盛时期都自身难保，如今他要以一个副首席部长的职位来骗取人民的委托，这根本就是在侮辱视角选民的智慧。可见人联党有这些证据也证明人联党有无副首席部长，不止对华社无关痛痒，甚至对其本身政党的权益也无关痛痒。更何况过去人联党在80年代州议会中的48个议席，占据了14个议席，那是29%的议席。如今州议会中的82个议席，就算给人联党赢完，他只占了13个议席，这是15%。好，在国政中的地位更加的弱，更加没有话事权。另外，沈桂贤口口声声说他与纳吉和阿迪南交情很好，而他又已是上议员了，为何他不能以上议员的身份为民争取权益，而偏偏一定要有副首席部长才能够替沙洲人民争取权益？敢问沈桂贤，他在担任上议员的这段日子里替沙洲人民争取到什么权利？好，这个等一下我会传给你们，给我你们的 email。 好，Okay, this is just to report the main campaign team of SUPP in Batukawa. Basically, SUPP and Barisan Nasional is hanging the carrot, and that carrot for the Batukawa voters, that carrot is that Dr. Sim will become the deputy chief minister.Right. What I have listed just now, there are 9 incidents where SUPP had a deputy chief minister, but yet their power, their rights has been diminished by the Barisan Nasional over the years. In 1980s, SUPP had 3 ministers, full minister in the state cabinet, but of when it comes to 2000, SUPP only had 2 full ministers in the cabinet. And Kuching City The chairman was SUPP, and in the 1980s, it was divided into two city, two council, with City North and City South. And SUPP was given only City South, which is one third of the surface area of the original Kuching City. Right, Belaga seat was originally SUPP, but it was taken by PBB. And Nangka seat was supposed to be SUPP because it is cut out from SUPP seat. It was also taken by PBB. Alright, SUPP used to have the Minister of Finance. It was taken away from SUPP by the CM. Alright, SUPP used to be the chairman of SESCO, and that was also taken away by PBB. And all this happened before 2006. That means before SUPP lost any seats, lost their seats to DAP in the urban area. Alright, in 2006, SUPP lost 6-6 to DAP. But before that, all this has happened. Alright, so therefore, I think for SUPP to have a DCM or not, or otherwise, it does not matter. Does not matter for their party's right position and rights. It does not matter to the people of Sarawak. All right, it only matters for Dr. Sim Kui Hian personally. What more to say? Previously, in 1980s, SUPP, at that time, DUN has only 48 seats. SUPP stood in 14 seats. That was about 29% of the total DUN seat. Now, they have DUN, we have 82 seats, but SUPP only stood in 13 seats. That's reduced from 29% in the DUN to 15%, 1-5. You see, so their position is not even weaker. So therefore, whether there is a deputy chief minister or not, it does not matter at all to the people. It does not affect the people's rights. Or it does not even affect SUPP's rights in a position in Barisan Nasional, because they don't have any position anyway. All right. Okay. That's it. Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Yeah. My one is more to reply to the advertisement, Chinese advertisement. So I will just speak in Chinese on the local issue about the business erosion of Padungan, whereby SUPP has put the blame on me. So today I want to reply on the real reason of the Kuching Old Street, the erosion, the reason for the erosion of the business. 今天我要，the business is getting back, alright. 今天我要回应就是这一个报章上的一个所谓被所谓一瓶这个一群佛罗岸这个选民所登的这个广告。我这个有把它打出来的在我的手机，我等下可以用 WhatsApp 还是 email 这样给你们哈。OK， 就是人脸党的语调，虽然是讲放这个一群这个佛罗岸区选民的广告，但是却是人脸党的语调。这个特别是这个人脸党竞选团队佛罗岸区竞选团队的这个语调，就是人脸党把这个古晋老街生意量下跌。归咎给我，今天我要揭露这个老街古晋老街下生意量下跌的真实原因。为什么我要把古晋老街生意量下跌的真实原因告诉这个人脸党呢？因为很明显的，他们不知道，佛罗岸街生意量下跌的原因， 为什么我说他们不知道呢？因为昨天包九松在这个Open Air Market 才开始收集民意，昨天是倒数竞选倒数的第四天，他才开始收集民意，可见他们没有准备来竞选，没有做好功课来竞选。OK， 也不知道这里发生什么事情，人民面对到的问题。今天我就要告诉他们真实面对，他们面对生意量下跌的真实的原因。第一个，古晋老街生意越来越难做，四大原因。第一个就是老巴萨的关闭，老巴萨的关闭，历史悠久的老巴萨关闭，是有政治阴谋，就是，菜市场往往是吸引人潮最主要的元素。当时有一片空地位于树洞，树洞原本是建议要拿来，就建这个二小，但是人联党的多位领袖却把它变成发展成为99间的店铺，成为私人牟利的用途，这些我全部有打在里面，就是现在的树洞菜市场旁边的这些商业店，不仅如此，人联党多位的领袖也因此分到其中不少的店铺。然后为了让当时的这个苏东店铺可以成为租金高的商业区，人联党领袖就建议建一间巨型的这个菜市场，密谋把这个小贩从老巴萨还有大湾摘鸭的菜市场，集中在苏东的菜市场。也因为这样，历史悠久的老巴萨和大湾摘鸭的菜市场就被搬迁，全部集中在苏东菜市场，因此所有的小贩要在同一个的苏东菜市场里面竞争，其实只是为了汇集人联党的领袖，所以导致这个古晋老区没有人潮，因为菜市场关闭。第二就是关闭旧法庭路，为了照顾彭党的私利，关闭旧法庭路是为了要建这个 Medica Plaza， 建造这个购物商场，国政政府连路都可以给彭党，当时候火箭反对关闭这个路，而人联党确实跟彭党站在一起。道路的关闭导致整个古晋区交通 流畅性出现很大的问题，所以导致很多人不愿意去这个老区。第三就是 GST， 消费税的实施导致 GST 导致生意量急速的降低，人们的这个可消费的收入 disposable income 已经大不如前，不能够消费。这不只是福隆岸商家的问题，而是全马商家的问题。第四就是 1NDB 的丑闻导致马币贬值的幅度比其他的国家都严重。首相纳吉对 1NDB 的这个丑闻拖拖拉拉无法给予解释，导致马币贬值的幅度比其他国家都严重。马币贬值使商家的成本提高，因为无论是原料或者是成品的进口，单单货币兑换率的差异就已经造成成本的加剧，所以这使本地的生意面对到严重的打击，成本提高了许多，生意就难做，所以这就是为什么我们看到生意难做的四大原因，所以人联党把它归咎给我，就是讲我中选了5年，导致这一个生意量大跌，人联党很可见已经跟这个社会脱节了，不知道商家的这个心态。 Alright， 还有一个就是，昨天跟今天这个佛龙岸区我们看到这个对我开始一系列的这个人身的攻击，人身的攻击，特别是在这个阳历昨天有这个宴会的时候，人联党有宴会的时候，地包主松拉票的时候，杨丽他的演讲和他在这个过去人联党佛罗岸区的演讲里面，都是进行对我的人身攻击。所以我觉得这一次的竞选在佛罗岸区似乎是我和杨丽之间的竞选，就是包九松不在这个画面里面，都是杨丽出马，用这种人身的攻击来这个攻击我，用这种人格的谋杀的这种策略，把这个民主行动党或者我的这个声望来拉低，以要这个赢得这一场的选战，所以我在之前已经讲过， 在选举的时候，我最期望的是一个君子之交。好，君子之交就是之战，好，君子之战就是这个，我们讲议题，我们讲这个关系到人民的这个课题来辩论。好，但是我发现到人联党却是用这种比较低级的好这个手段好来进行宣传，就是打我的这个个人的人格问题。好，我的人格，如果这个人联党成功，好，就算人联党成功把我的这个人格谋杀掉，使我在出去的时候满街人吐我口水，人民的问题还是没有被解决到。所以我个人的这个人格问题，我要跟这个人联党说，我个人的这个人格好的问题，他说哦，我太高傲，都是去到外地去竞选呐，帮忙竞选呐，没有这个还有今天在这个老巴萨分发了这个讲我以前比较瘦，现在比较胖呐，之类的这种人格谋杀，没有关系到人民议题的这个东西，就算我的这个人格被谋杀掉，好，这个人民的问题还是存在。所以竞选就是要让人民的问题直接能够获得重视。所以我个人的这个人格问题，还是他用这个人格的谋杀的方式，好，绝对不能够帮助到人民，好的生活会过得更好。所以人联党如果要君子来打这一场选战的话，他必须要这个回到正规，就是回到辩论议题方面。因此我抛出两个问题给人联党。第一，就是对于阿丁南在他做首席部长期间里面贱卖土地，沙洲土地一阴谋一亿价300块，还有贱卖 MJC 的土地，这个人联党的立场是什么？第二，人联党为什么当初要支持消费税，使到人民的生活现在雪上加霜？两个问题。It's a better not between me and Peter Pao, but it's a better between me and Lily Yong. It's a better between me and Lily Yong. Because Lily Yong has launched personal attack in his speech, and also I understand that he has just concentrate on attacking me personally. Try to launch the character assassination against me. Try to lower the reputation, my reputation, and also DAP's reputation in Padungan area. For the purpose to win this election in Padungan. So I would say that this is election tactic. Is uncalled for election tactic, and even my character has been badly damaged. And people's if my character has been badly damaged, the election is about people. It's not about my personal character, or what is whether I'm fat or thin, you know. This is also an issue now, whether I have a bigger size in body, alright. They also brought it as an issue. It's a personal character assassination. The election is concentrating on the people's problem. SUPP can attack me personally or attack on my personal character, but the problem of the people has not been solved. The issues of the people concerning people has not been addressed in this election. Therefore, I want to urge SUPP and also Lily Yong to come back to the correct track. address the issue, answer the issues, and we fight gentlemanly. Therefore, I pose two questions to SUPP, Balungan. Number one, what is the SUPP stand on the land alienation scandal that I exposed about that during the tenure of Adnan administration? Land has been sold cheaply, 30,000 acres of land has been sold cheaply at the price of 300 per acre. What is SUPP stand? Number two, why SUPP supported the implementation of GST, which caused the hardship to the people? All right, two questions. So we come back to the right track, the correct track, and we do it in the gentleman way and democratic way. Personal attack, character assassination is nothing to do, or it will not bring any benefit to the people, and the issue of concerning the people will not be addressed. Also, they have went on to the very wrong track, and they have used a very underhand tactic to win the election, try to win the election, and this is something uncalled for. All right.
Okay, there are two more things. Quick one. Number one, about Sri Aman Independent, I've received news, feedback from our party. That one I've written also in the Chinese statement. I've received feedback from our party members, campaigners, canvassers in Sri Aman that the independent candidate, Datuk Ngo Piao Sek, all right, his people on the ground are claiming that they will join DAP if he were elected. He may join DAP. Right. I, as the state chairman of DAP, I here unequivocally state our party position that we will not accept him, even if he wins and he applies to join DAP. DAP will not accept someone who openly stood against our party candidate, and after that, turning around and asking to join DAP. All right, we have our members working hard and our candidates working hard in the areas, in the respective areas where they're contested. All right, and for the independents to stand against them, he is standing against the whole party, the DAP Sarawak as a whole. And we will not stoop so low as to even consider accepting him as a member. All right, we are not Barisan Nasional. Okay, that's number one. Number two, all right, in the three-corner fight of Batu Kitang, right, from the last few days of campaigning and also the campaigning and the feedback from the ground, well, initially Aziz's percentage was 40-45. Now the feedback now, even the study is that our feedback now is he has gained a lot of ground. He's now reached 48, bordering 49%. All right, so he stands a very good chance of a real chance to win the race in Batu Kitang. All right, as such, I call upon, all right, I appeal to PKR to drop out, to withdraw, declare their withdrawal, as the ground's feedback is that, you know, PKR has no chance of even winning whatsoever, has no chance absolutely of winning Barisan Nasional anymore. They have dropped out of the race, and therefore I call upon PKR to look at the big picture, and I declare their withdrawal. All right, so because Aziz has a real chance of winning. He is now about 49% in a three-corner fight. All right, putting aside the two independents, we don't have to look at them. Okay, in a three-corner fight. Okay, so he has a real chance of capturing. I mean, let's look at the big picture. All right, even bigger than Pakatan Harapan. Okay, even bigger than Pakatan Harapan, a picture where you have a Malay state of Malay opposition state assemblyman, right, in the Sarawak State Assembly. That is the big picture. A multiracial lineup of the opposition. That is the big picture. Right, bigger than Pakatan Harapan in Sarawak. Right, let us I'll call upon PKR to put aside his their personal feelings and look at the struggle for the struggle for democracy in Sarawak. Let us have the first young opposition Malay adult in the state assembly. Right, so that the opposition will have all the races represented in the state assembly after 7th of May. Okay, therefore I call upon, I appeal to PKR, since they have no chance of winning anymore in Batu Kitang, let's not help Loh Ke Chiang to win the race. Although I know PKR's candidate Boon Siak Ni is a good friend of Loh Ke Chiang, please do not help him to win the race. Okay, that is my sincere appeal to PKR and their leadership. Alright? 在这里，好，我在以华语再讲一下，就是从过去的几天的 campaign， 好，阿杜 Aziz 从开始的 45% 根据我们的 feedback， 我们的回得到的基层的回应，已经增加到 49% 了，就是差一点点了，那么是在这种情况之下，而且是在一个三角站的情况下，两个独立人士我们把它摆一边了，完全不需要去考虑。 或在国政党、行动党跟人联党这三个政党的对垒，这情况之下，他已经进步到增加到49%的这个，还输一点点，就输一点点，所以在那一点点，我在这里诚心的呼吁共产党退出这一次的选举，公布退出这次的选举，因为从我们的基层的回应。 共产党已经完全无法去赢这场大选，这个 Batu Kitang 的这场仗，完全无法。我们希望共产党能够顾全大局，看大个局。这个大个局在沙捞越的政坛，在沙捞越的政治，比西联在沙捞越更大。比西联的存在，希望联盟不是西联，希望联盟。 这存在更大，因为他是阿德阿基将有可能，也极有可能成为第一位马来人的反对党的州议员，第一位马来人的反对党的州议员，他将他的如果他的竞选将会开拓整个一个沙捞越政坛的新格局，吸引更多马来人进入加进反对党的行列。 也让整个反对阵线有各族的代表，就是华人、一般人、闽南裔人、欧朗乌鲁，甚至马来的代表。所以今天的战情在巴杜比当，既然公正党是无法胜的，已经是无法胜的。从我们看过去的几场的这个群众会议，跟这个民众的反应。 已经是无法胜出这场战役了。公正党的温夏尼的坚持还是要再打这场战役，只是帮助罗克强。当然我知道，我了解温夏尼和罗克强交情很好，但是我们在政治上，我们应该抛开这个私交，应该以 朝野政治各局的利益的这个考量为出发点，而抛开是这样，他的继续的留着在打这场选战，没有赢球的机会，只有帮助罗克强胜出的机会，所以我们希望，共产党高层能够顾全大局。 在沙劳越创造一个新的政治格局，这个考量而宣布退出这个巴杜基丹的这场战役。 OK Yes， 他的这个他的竞选的团队是这样讲的。如果他认为这个是不对的，而且他可以自己宣布说他不会加入，他不会申请加入行动的。不，我们行动的，因为我们的竞选团队在基层走动的时候，他们讲哎，那个也一样的嘛，他赢了，他讲他们会加进行动的嘛，所以搞到斯里安曼的人很混乱。所以他要求我在这里以党主席党沙洲主席的身份来做一个澄清，我们不会接受这种跟党候选人对战的人士加进行动的。好了。
I just want to clarify,
you know,
50% what Matita
gets is his own collection of... feedback. Our feedback, and also some of the government agencies' feedback. Alright? Government agencies' feedback. Okay, it's now 49% already. Lovely day already, almost 50%. And now a few more charamas, I think we can... go beyond that.
What was the percentage of support for
Never mind, don't worry. Alright. not very good for me to say that. Okay, alright. Now the whole thing is, I think they are out of the race already. PKI is out of the race so far as Batu Kita is concerned. They are out of the race, so don't help Barisan Nasional to win Batu Kita. Okay, that's my call, my appeal. To PKR.
Okay. Do you have any expectation
on this side?
How many seats
that
we can win?
Any
additional
ships
or some
seats? No, I think I'll wait for another, not today, the expectation. Okay? Alright?
Okay.
没有，我要公正党。好，他本身只是公正党的候选人，应该是由公正党。啊？没有，我们这个就是在这场战役了，我们就看马杜基丹的这场战役。现在也不是讲谈判，
好，也
其他的不要。我们现在看你到底要在沙劳越，然后希望他们能够考量在沙劳越能够有一个新的政治格局，啊，因为阿基斯的机会是非常的高的。OK， 从他的观众。群众对他的演讲的反应，和他的受欢迎度 ，I think Aziz's popularity amongst the drama goers, I think is very obvious. It's quite obvious amongst the youngsters. All right, the acceptance of Aziz is there already. It is there. It is rising. All right. Therefore, I think he sent a good chance. Okay.I'm not talking about seat negotiation anymore, or changing of seat anymore. I'm talking about.Let's create history. Okay, let's create history. We are also always calling on the people, our voters, to create history. Okay, therefore, as a political party, I think since they are out of the race, no point for them to continue unless the purpose is to help Barisan Nasional. Right, no point for them to continue already. I think if you go, if you look at the campaigning in these the last few days,It is obvious that the groundswell support for the DAP and Aziz, the acceptance of Abdul Aziz, all right, and so it is obvious that in so far as Batu Kitang is concerned, PKI is out of the race already. Okay, the other areas I'm not there all full time. I can't speak for the other party, the other areas.But so far as Batu Kitang is concerned, I think PKI is out of the race. Right? It is now between the race between DAP and Barisan Nasional. And therefore, I think given such a circumstances, they should, they are opposition. Right? Although, okay, we may not be working together, but they are opposition. And our common enemy should be Barisan Nasional. Right? One more seat reduction for Barisan Nasional,is one more strength for the opposition, and that's it. That is the consideration. Alright, therefore I'm not talking about seat negotiation, switching what seat for what seat. Alright, but this Batu Kintang is concerned. So far as the battle in Batu Kintang is concerned.
Maybe what about your seat?
Hmm?
How is the race
between you and Wilfred? Hmm? Me and Wilfred? I'm very worried. I'm very worried about the army votes. How it is going to affect. Especially given that 6,000 of my normal voter has been moved out from my area. Alright, that is my worry. 6,000 of my normal voters has been moved out compared to the last election. Last election, I have about 30,000 voters. Now I have about 25,000 voters. He's asking on the, alright? So given that there is a huge reduction of my normal voters, whereas the army voters has increased by another few hundred. I think this is a very grey area, and my appeal to the voters in Kota Sentosa, please come out to vote. Alright? Huh? Army vote 3,000 plus, more than 3,000. Because they include their spouses and everything. Army vote, police vote. So. Yeah.
Okay. How about the civil seat? Because when I say cannot stop the sekolah menengah isu.
Huh?
The Bondi Limon play the isu of sekolah menengah cannot.
Who?
Bondi Limon. JP candidates at the civil.
Yeah.
How about the chance to
maybe
win at the
SMK Singai? You mentioned.
SMK Singai.
Abandoned project of SMK Singai.
Yeah, now it's solved already.
No. No.
Huh? Has it been solved?
Not solved by the destination.
Has it been solved? Not solved. Well, I think it's for the people to judge. I think that is the role of opposition. You know, we bring out all these issues. Hopefully it can be solved.
You wanted to deliberate on this request for you to present your report.
I've already done it, isn't it? Then if you don't, you can take a photo there. He showed you two files of what he has done the past 2 years. Over there is about 50 files of what I have done in the past 10 years. So basically, 5 files take one year, about 50 files. His one is 2 files, what, 2 years, is it? 1 year, okay, never mind. 2 files, 1 year. Mine is 5 files, 1 year. There are about 50 files there. Okay, all right. So, well, the volume of work that we do, there's a quite obvious difference
for scientists.
Huh? CM. CM 挑战过什么? CM? I think that 挑战过什么? I think that 根本就是在歪曲我们的话。 我们所说的是这一届的这个周选将影响来届国选的成绩，如果我们赢更多将会带动 全国人民制造第三波政治海啸，进而改朝换代，就是换政府，换 federal government。要换 federal government， 你就必须要在这一次的选举，行动党赢比上一次更多的议席，包括一些乡村议席。 OK， 这个是我们强调的。我们整个大选没有说连说要换沙州政府都没有，我们甚至说你阿迪丹还是做政府，好，我们只要否决你三分二。好，这样的口号，这样的目标，他怎样去把它歪曲成为我们胜了周选呢、啊？胜了几个议席就可以废除消费税？你要歪曲人的言论，也要歪曲的有一点点合理，太荒谬了。所以我们讲的就是这一次的周选将会成为下一次国选来届国选的一个前哨战。好，所以如果我们赢更多，就有机会改朝换代，到时就可以消除消费税了。OK， 在联邦之政还可以够消除消费税吗？所以阿迪丹根本就是在讲废话。好 ，OK。直接 absorb 吗？明天是 absorb，
就跟沙洲一样。
没有，
消除消费税跟
absorb
不一样呀。
所以在明天是
absorb。沙洲我不清楚，你要问阿迪娜。
有一个环。
等我做政府了，我告诉你。不过那个要等五年后。第四波政治还是这样，对吧？
不过有一个阿迪南哈，他这个就是这个州政府在槟城跟雪兰莪是 absorb 掉所有州政府 state services 哦的 GST， but 阿迪南在沙劳越很重要的一个 GST 他没有 absorb 掉，就是这个电费的 GST 他没有 absorb 掉，我们还在还电费的 GST， 就是超过 state authority 哦。为什么这个西马不一样？西马是电是肯纳加 under federal， so this 不可能这个州政府能够收。不过在沙劳越 Cisco 是 under 州政府，所以那一个单那一个是最吃力，每一个月都在 charge 人的 GST from 这个州政府的 service 哦。
OK，
这个没有收。
Yeah。
啊？哦 ，English。
English 啊。okay, her question is, Adinan, say, you know, how did he say?
In Penang and Selangor first.
Because he are saying that we say if we win, we will abolish GST or something, you know, things like that. Alright, we never say that we will abolish GST if we win this state election. Okay, what we are saying is that you know, the results of this state election will affect the result of the coming general election. Okay? This will be the start. This will be the impetus for the general election. Okay? And it's only through winning the general elections that we can abolish GST or reduce it to 0%. So I call on Adina not to twist our words and put words in my mouth that we have not said. Okay. Ah, 五个安德拉斯啊，我忘记了。Okay.
有录音的。
禁止我们的领袖禁止，但是允许不同的部长全部进来，这个是安全手段喽，这个还不够肮脏，这个很肮脏啊。
他说他们进来是法案，而且和反对党进来是
破坏。他们进来呢？
他们带进来
乌统。你如果能够接受的话，我也没有话讲过这种话。
这种逻辑，
啊，这种逻辑啊。
然后第二个是
阿米啊，军人跟他们的家属都可以投票。好，西马军人跟家属可以投票，
可以在沙劳越投，
可以在沙劳越投票啊。西马呢？西马军人呢？跟他的家属。
本来就有家
啊？过去没有那么多了，没有那么多了。好，而且问题是，这一次的选举是阿迪娜所说的关系沙洲主权的。啊，既然关系沙洲主权，你就不应该允许这些人来投票了吗？啊 ，OK， 这个是第二。第三的是，啊，那我的手机现在都给人家去，不知道用什么技术把它弄到，好像我乱传进去这样。第四，啊，好，在 Facebook 上，啊，以污蔑的那种言论来污蔑，歪曲我们的言论跟污蔑。And then 第五就是滥用国政的机啊政府的机制和金钱来帮助选举。OK， 谢谢。好。哎，有钱拿来。
这是我的。
哦，这灵光一哦。
我想要签名。我是。